Hi everybody, welcome back to Glowing Card Gaming. Again, I am Adam, your host. I know that was maybe a little awkward, but again, I recorded 1.5 videos with no sound, so I'm back at it. Just trying to think about, in the video I just posted, which isn't quite all the way up just yet, I managed to get all the content that I had the first time amazingly back into it. Maybe even a little more. I think it came out even better than I did the first time. So hopefully this one also will do that. So we're gonna do our picks against the spread. I didn't even watch the Pat McAfee show this week because I don't even think they have it up yet for their picks. So we're beating them to the punch. I'm beating somebody to the punch. I guess that's just the way it is. So let's get into it. Start with the Thursday night game, which is the Seattle Seahawks at the Dallas Cowboys. I think that Dallas is still the scoring juggernaut that they have been. Do the Seahawks stop them from scoring? That's the real question. I'm not sure what the answer is on that. I hate these big point totals and big spreads and stuff. I actually was thinking about picking Seattle, and I think I might have the first time I did this video. But I'm going to change it, and I'm going to take the Cowboys -9. All right, I'm just notating some stuff. That way it makes it easier when I'm doing the recap show next week. Cowboys -9 in game one. So we're going to move on down the list here. The next one I have listed is the LA Chargers at the New England Patriots. Chargers favored by 6. The Patriots are such a mess. And even as bad as the Chargers were last week, I still think they cover that. So I'm going to take the Chargers +6 on that. I'm just using Notepad. So it's just a quick little note on here. We're going to take Chargers -6. There's not 6.5 or 9.5. No, it's even. So we could have some ties. We could have some ties. And then we have the Miami Dolphins at the Washington Commanders. And this is also a morning game. Are we going to learn from Thanksgiving Day and take all the big point differentials? Sure. Why not? Dolphins, 9.5. I probably missed that one, but it's not like I'm actually betting money on this. So Dolphins -9.5. All right, and then here's one of the games of the week. Broncos at Texans. Texans are favored by 3.5. I actually think they might have missed this one. Broncos are just so hot, and the defense is solid. And I'll talk about this more in my Broncos recap for the Browns game and what I think for the Texans upcoming, but that'll be later in the week. That we'll drop that video. But as you can probably tell, I am going to pick the Broncos +3.5. Yeah, all day. All day. It's going to be really close, a scoring game anyway. And getting that 3.5 probably gives the edge in that bet to the Broncos. If I forgot to mention it, using the Bet ESPN app to look look at these stats and make my picks. Now, one other side note right in the middle here. Sorry, I should have did this at the beginning of the video, but I was right about the logo. It's a teal B with the ESPN E inside of it. But you only see that on the app on your phone. The website has this big fat round B for whatever reason. It looks weird, which I'm glad they went to the logo they have currently for the phone. So I prefer this one. Just throwing that out there. So we have the Broncos 3.5. Let me knock that down. Plus 3.5. So that's a nice one. I think that's almost a lock. I don't really do locks. I'm not going to say, oh, this is... If you're going to bet one game this week, this would be it. I'm not putting in a lock. Forget it. Next one, we have Falcons minus 3 over the Jets. Jets are such a horrendous mess. I can't believe it's only 3 points. Should be like 9.5, 10, 12, 14, something ridiculous. Being that it's only 3, of course I'm going to take the Falcons minus 3 in this. Now watch the Jets win it. We'll see what happens, but I think that's the correct call. We have the Detroit Lions at New Orleans. Thinking about the games last week, the Lions losing at home to Green Bay. Man, minus 4. I think I'm going to go Saints plus 4 in this one. I just wonder if something changed in the Lions, maybe the locker room or with the staff, the coaching, and they've gone back kind of their old ways where, you know, they're good enough maybe to get to the playoffs, but not good enough to win more than a playoff game. Like back when they had Barry Sanders. Just watch Bye-Bye Barry on Prime. Highly recommend. Kind of disappointed in why Barry left the league when he did. I thought there was more to it, but you know, I really don't want to spoil anything, but it's not earth shattering, and I don't think I'm really giving anything away there. Not if you really paid attention to his career and how he did things. So, I'm going to take the Saints plus 4. Now we have the Arizona Cardinals at the Pittsburgh Steelers. And Steelers by 5.5. Cardinals are so bad. Give me the Steelers at minus 5.5. I can't imagine Steelers are going to... I don't think the Steelers will lose, but do they win by 5.5? That's the real question. I think the Cardinals are so bad. The Steelers might actually put up some more points. The Steelers have not been a high-scoring team, but I think they might win this by 7 or 10 on this one. So 5.5. Steelers minus 5.5. Give it to me. Give me some sugar, baby. All right, got it locked in for my recap next week. So tune in for that. We'll see how well I did. Next game that I have slated here is the Indianapolis Colts at the Tennessee Titans. This one's almost a jump ball. This is a divisional game. These are so difficult to call. Colts minus 1 in this one. So they're favored by by one. They're on the road at Tennessee. I mean, this is probably the toughest one to call so far of this week. At least even in who's going to win and lose. So the Colts are favored by one. Sometimes people just kind of play lights out. I'm wanting to pick the Colts, but I think this might be the upset. So give me the Titans plus one. Boy, this is a lot tougher. To be fair, you know, if I was just picking straight win loss, last week I would have actually been 11-5. I would have gotten two more. The point spread actually killed me on two games. So if you watch that recap, you know, you would know that. So so take that as you will for this week. I'm trying to learn from my mistakes last week on the big spreads and all of that, and trying to not have so much of a mindset of, oh, this is just what I've seen in the past. It's a whole new year, whole new league, different rules, all of that stuff. So we have it going on. So next game I have on the schedule is the Panthers and the Buccaneers. Bucks minus 5.5. Until the Panthers prove me wrong, I'm picking against them the whole way. I know they just fired their coach and there's a big shakeup there. The thing is, sometimes with different coaching coming in, that could change it. But do they do that week one? I've seen it where they have done it week one, but then I've also seen it where, you know, it takes 3 to 4 weeks before the interim head coach or the new coach is able to turn a program around. Well, until the Panthers prove me wrong, I'm going to pick against them. So give me the Bucks minus 5. Do I spell the whole thing out? Nah, we'll just do Bucks. Minus 5. It's not 5.5? Man, there's a lot of stuff that could be pushes this week. So we'll see what ends up happening. We got the Niners favored at the Eagles. Niners minus three at Eagles. Did they miss the line on this one? Eagles have been finding a way to win. I mean, even against that, last week? Was it Green Bay? The Lions, that's right. And the Eagles found a way to win that. I don't see... I mean, you're going to give me 3 points for the Eagles at home at 10-1. Give me the Eagles plus 3. I think that one is an easy one. Who knows? They probably blow it. We got the Cleveland Browns at the LA Rams. LA is favored by 3.5. After the Browns literally got destroyed by the Broncos, there's a lot of injuries there. They're down to their third string quarterback. I don't think they make enough of adjustments between last week and this week. This line should be more like 7 or 10 or something like that. So you're going to give me only minus 3.5 on the Rams. I'm taking the Rams minus 3.5. Okay. Chiefs at Green Bay. Chiefs are favored by 6.5. I also think they may have missed the line on this one. Have you guys been watching the Packers lately? Winning games, rolling. They are not as bad as they're kind of like the Broncos. They were bad earlier, and they are coming around, and they are doing better and better. This could be a trap game for KC, just like the Denver game was a trap game when no one knew the Broncos had already turned the corner and they were going to just win that one outright. Now, will the Chiefs win this one? They could still win it. But by 6.5, not against this Green Bay team. No way. I'll take Packers plus 6.5. I think this is sort of an easy call. Of course, I've not picked the Chiefs very well over the past few weeks, so take that as you will, and the Chiefs may win and win it, you know, by 21 or something ridiculous. You never know. The Chiefs do find ways to win games as well. So all that being said, do I think they win by 6.5, though? I don't think the Kansas City Chiefs win by 6.5. And here we go with the Cincinnati Bengals at Jacksonville Jaguars. Jacksonville minus 8. Another big point spread. You know how I love these. Anything over 7, I think, is considered big. 10 is enormous. Although earlier this year, I think somebody had a 14 or 16 point spread, and I think it was Dallas. They were favored. It was like Dallas minus 14. They did it. They won by like 30 in that one. So it's one of the few times I've seen that big of a point spread actually pay off for the team that was favored. That all being said, I think the favored teams, I think they're kind of getting them right this year. So, and the Bengals without Joe Burrow as a starting quarterback. Yeah, my fantasy league is wrecked now. I've lost 2 straight, including one to the guy with no wins. Was 0-10. Now he's 1-10. Or 1-11, I think he lost again last week. I haven't even checked this week. I think I lost again. So I could lose out and not make the playoffs in that. I only need one win to make playoffs in my fantasy league, and I can't get it. I can't get it. Frustrating. You guys are waiting for my pick. Sorry. All of that being said, I think they are pretty accurate on this. I'm going to take the Jags minus 8 on this one. And that will do it for this week. Jags minus 8. We made it. We did it. We made it all the way through the picks. Oh, my God. Yeah, that's all the picks. So, Cowboys minus 9, Chargers minus 6, Dolphins minus 9.5, Broncos plus 3.5, Falcons minus 3, Saints plus 4, Steelers minus 5.5, Titans plus 1, Bucks minus 5, Eagles plus 3, Rams minus 3.5, Packers plus 6.5, and the Jags minus 8. You got that? All right, good. We'll do the recap next week, and we'll see how I did. Just remember, I was 9-7 last week, so I'm 50-50 on these. So not great, but I used a lot of that knowledge I learned from last week and hopefully improved my picks this week. We'll see what happens. All right. Go ahead and make your picks and let me know if you think I glaringly missed something, like the Jags minus 8, if you think the Bengals really do have a shot to actually just win that, let me know in the comments. Or who else is there? Dolphins minus 9.5, Cowboys minus 9. You know, the big glaring, you know, maybe I did miss something. Let me know in the comments. Let me know if you think you're going to beat me this week. Let me know what you think my record will be at the end of this week, what your picks are, and we'll come back for the recap next week. Thank you all for tuning in to Glowing Card Gaming. Again, my name is Adam. Like, subscribe, and share this out. And as always, be good to each other. Thanks again.